Hi Sagittarius, I'm Anisha. You can write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com, and this is your annual forecast for 2012. Sagittarians, you've started this year with some phenomenal transits into your house. This year is all about change. Not a lot of change, but change still nonetheless within yourself. In the first half, Sagittarians, a lot of you are going to be doing a lot of self-work. And the second half is going to be more on the acceptance piece on yourself. Though since your 2011 may not have been very stable as far as your work has been concerned, 2012 is going to be seeing you move into a slightly more stable phase. So let's have a look at your career and finance and how it is placed for 2012. Sagittarians, this year the trend, and I'm going to be focusing more onto the latter part of the year. Sagittarians, this year there's been a lot of focus onto your career and your finance. For all those of you who have been dealing with either the broadcast media or any form of a communication, would have received not just a lot of accolades, but I think there would be a lot of public recognition for a lot of you. And this phase would start for you starting from second week of August 2012, and it carries on till about end of the year, or I would say even about first quarter of 2013. So that's a brilliant way to start your year, Sagittarians. However, try not to invest in anything risky this year, Sagittarians, and this really speaks about your last quarter. Try not to get involved in any harebrained schemes, and this per se has to do with either being in partnership with friends who would be showing you reasonable data, but it is advisable that not to really go ahead and put your money up over there. This is also a time this year around mid-year you will be negotiating either for a higher salary package, or you could also be negotiating for monies for contracts for deals. It speaks about a lot of deals and negotiations being done in midpoint of the year. You could be also be in the process of either picking up a new project, and this is around your September to October 2012, and a lot of you could also be trying to negotiate the terms and conditions around it. Around this time also, a lot of you could also be negotiating finances with a child. I think it could either be a child who is staying maybe not in the same country or not in the same city, and it could have to do with some sort of a negotiation agreement. And for some of you, it could just be negotiating with your children on the boundary lines of how they are and how they behave. We also have an interesting on September 19th. Yes, Uranus is going to be there in your fifth house, and Uranus is a planet of chaos, upheaval, unpredictability. And your fifth house is about love, romance, children, and a lot of pleasure. So Uranus is going to be there in your fifth house, and it is going to be adding a square to Pluto that is going to be there in your second house, that is the house of your earned income. Hence you could expect some amount of a friction also going on about partnerships, about with regards to money. So watch out for that time. Try not to end up being in a very confrontational space over there. We'll have a look at your love and relationships for 2012, Sagittarius. November 28th, there is a lunar eclipse in your 7th house. Your 7th house is all about partnerships, it's about marriage, it's about committed contracts. And with lunar eclipse on the November 28th, it's just going to be highlighting this part of the year. And there could be either a sense of competition in your relationships, or you could just feel some amount of a power struggle within your partnerships. It could be at your work, and it could also be applicable at your personal space. Sagittarians, having a warm and an honest approach is something which will see you through it. So try not to get too bogged in by over analysis or trying to assume things, but try and keep things simple. Try and deal with people with complete honesty and a lot of warmth. It will just be fine. There's also a great time when Jupiter is in direct motion in your seventh house. That was somewhere around June 11th, but it carries on till about October 5th. And this effect of your Jupiter, that is a planet of expansiveness, it is going to be there with you till about, I would say, June 2013. The effect of Jupiter, which is a good thing. I think the moment Jupiter touches a part of our chart that has to do with dealing with other people, especially as far as partnership is concerned, it just sort of expands things. So try and watch out your ego as well, because it could add a bit of expansiveness over there as well. We have Saturn that is going to be transiting your 11th house. Now, 11th house is all about friendships. It's about long distance travel. And it also speaks about education, higher education. So a lot of you this year, Sagittarians, are going to be very, very selective about the kind of friends that you hang around with. You're not just going to be, being happy, just being a part of a large crowd or a herd. I think maybe last year, maybe the trend was not to worry or bother about who it is that you are going out or hanging around with. But this year, the focus is going to be you being more selective about who it is that you would like to be with. And this specially speaks about your friends as well. Neptune also enters your fourth house, and Neptune is a planet of dreams. It's a planet that causes some amount of a delusion, a lot of self-delusion. And it could make you look at things in a very unrealistic way. So try not to, especially, and since it is there in your fourth house, try not to look at things which are quite unrealistic, whether you're looking at an ideal family scenario or you're looking at, this also has to do something to do with your parents and going back to your roots. So you may be trying to recreate an ideal scenario for yourself, Sagittarians. Watch out for that. So overall, a brilliant year, Sagittarians. Stay a little bit more patient, some amount of more stability this year, and this will carry on for you in 2013 as well. Have a great year. I'll see you soon, and thank you so much for watching.